Indirect ophthalmoscopy is one of the most confusing clinical examination in ophthalmology. Not to say it takes time to master the skill as well. Most of the confusion happens in understanding the location and applying the fact that the image is inverted. So we try to simplify this by two examples. So now we imagine this pen as a retina and we have to examine the periphery, that means the back end and the cap. Now when I examine the bottom end of the pen, I will see the bottom only. I will not see the cap. Only thing, its orientation would be changed. So you can compare with the original image and now you would understand what it means by an inverted image. So we will put this into practice and understand what happens if we see the superior periphery. So when the patient looks up, we are examining the superior periphery and this is what we see in our indirect. But the image is inverted and this is what is actually there. But we are still seeing the superior periphery and it is not the inferior periphery. Only the orientation of the breaks change. Does that mean even when I am seeing the posterior pole, whatever is superior and inferior is inferior? No. So now if you are seeing this pen in entirety, you will see the entire pen is inverted. And that is what happens when seeing the posterior pole. At the posterior pole, whatever appears superior is inferior and what is inferior is superior. So remember, only the orientation changes. That means if the patient is looking up and you are examining the superior periphery, then it is indeed the superior periphery. Only the orientation of the lesions or the blood vessels is changed.